Hi, my name's Al Cossar. I'm a programmer at the Melbourne International Film Festival. One of the big changes that has happened for 2012 with the festival is really a digital transition where we're now screening a lot more from a digital format called DCP than we are 35mm as we have done in the past. Last year we screened 22 films on DCP and it's 134 this year. 190 35mm films last year and now we're down to 40. So it's a huge sort of tipping point in the way that we present films to an audience. And we've tried to make that a part of the festival theme this year as well. We have a panel called Final Reel, The End of Film, which is talking about digital futures and the move away from 35. We have a 16mm film workshop as well. And we also are screening side by side the Chris Keneally film, which is looking at the impact of digital technologies on storytelling. So as much as it's changed the festival technically and logistically, we also wanted to engage with it in terms of our programming as well. We see a huge amount of films at the festival in terms of our programming selection and process. The festival program is over 330 films this year from all around the world. There's a huge degree of familiarity with the convention as well, so one of the things that I particularly like is just to simply be surprised to find a film that has a rare quality about it, and that could be in the elements of the story, or it could be in the way that the story is articulated as well. I love to come out of a film and want to talk about it or argue about it or have some kind of impassioned response to it with a group of people afterwards. So we're always looking for films that are going to be there for people to react to differently and to react to in combination and talk about together as well. And this year, there are a whole lot of things that we do every year and that are there for an audience, but we have a whole lot of special interest strands as well. We have a Swedish film strand, which looks at new unseen, underseen work by Swedish directors, a Swedish criminal cinema focus as well. We have a variety of retrospectives, Leos Carax, 70s Hollywood, Jean Epstein as well. So there are particular contexts that we program into from year to year. And I guess one of the most important things about programming is that you're not programming individual films, you're building a program of films for an audience. So everything you do and everything you select happens in the context of every other decision you make. So we build programs for an audience rather than select individual films, I think. This year there's a whole lot of films I'm really excited about audiences seeing in the program. One of my favourites is Only the Young, which is part of our Next Gen section, directed by Sean Fine and Andrea Nixfine. It's a documentary portrait of three teenagers, two boys and a girl, in sort of suburban backwater Arizona, and they're punk skater kids and Christians as well. And the documentary is just a beautiful sort of intimate portrait of this love triangle that sort of develops between the kids in the backdrop of this sort of broken down Arizona and sort of suburban kind of environment. And it's so intimate, it just feels like a narrative. If you like something like I'm 11 last year, this is a really, really fantastic film. Room 237, which looks at the hidden codes and conspiracies behind Stanley Kubrick's The Shining, I think is just a fantastic film to see in a packed room full of film nerds. It's just a lot of fun. Oslo 31 August by Joachim Trier is a very melancholic, haunting sort of tale of 24 hours in the life of someone on day leave from a drug rehab facility, which stayed with me a lot. It was from Cannes last year as well. And Bart Layton's The Imposter tells a truth is absolutely stranger than fiction story, which I think audiences are gonna really jump out, and I can't wait to be in the room to see it with them.